Hey guys, what's up? I'm here to give you guys my final recap and final thoughts on Dungeon に出会いを求めるのは間違っているだろうか III, or is it wrong to pick up girls in the dungeon on season 3 on episode 12? Now, this episode right here, wow, what a way to freaking finish off in that kind of finale, etc. And I'm pretty sure the adventure is not over yet, and I'm looking forward to more, and hopefully we'll get to see more adventures after this. And I will tell you the truth, which I should be, you know what, I'll save this for later, alright? So if anything else, let's just get this started. We have two of the Hermes ask some of the Xenos to die because he's actually trying to restore Belle's honor because of what happened recently in the events that had come about, you know? We have two of the Gross and some other people decides to volunteer and they end up having to cause some trouble and Belle's forced to step in. He even has, although Belle is very hesitant to do anything right now, and Hermes doesn't like the idea of monsters trying to coexist with humans, you know, it's really troubling. And we see to it, of course, as the episode continues on, you know, we have to it that, that Gross was unable to actually maybe damage Belle or maybe attack him after he left himself wide open on purpose. But we have to it that Belle gets in, that battle gets interrupted by Belle and Gross by the Black Minotaur, who apparently is Asterius, you know, his name is Asterius, obviously. And he ends up being, at the beginning of the episode, we have to it that Altar tells Asterius what you're looking for lies beyond, so good luck. And we have to it that the Freya family is actually intervening right now. They even start to look familiar not to intervene at all because this is to actually help Belle out. Even the guy who apparently, even the guy with wolf ears who stopped the Amazonian twins whatsoever tells him we're trying to get this kid's honor back on track, you know, that kind of thing. And we see to it that Belle clashes against Asterius after they exchange a couple words. And it looks like to me Asterius' voice actor did a nice job. He doesn't seem very aggressive or he doesn't sound very hateful. He talks in a nice, calm manner, and I give props to the voice actor, even though he only had a role in this episode, really slick. He ends up telling Belle that he's been having this dream that a human and I have been clashing against each other. So it's true. This is where Asterius is the Black Minotaur or the Minotaur from Season 1 that Belle fought and they end up clashing against each other. And he is a reincarnation of Asterius as he is now, you know? And it's really slick, you know? We have to that he challenges Belle to a rematch right now. And we see to it that Asterius and Belle clash against each other and Altar ends up throwing a sword to Belle saying that let this give you a helping hand. And we see to it Belle takes a after one of Belle's weapons broke, he ends up seeing a big broad sword that he saw in season 1 whatsoever, and then takes it into his hand, and they end up clashing against each other, and it looks like they seem to be on par. But as time continues on, people can only cheer for Belle going, go, 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 go get him, man, as Belle's respect and honor is being restored, you know? I thought it was pretty nice to see how Belle is fighting against Asterius very greatly on par, you know? But eventually, when it came to the final blows, Asterius overpowers Belle's attack when it came to the final clash against each other, and Asterius ends up slamming Belle to the ground after going to the dungeon and not winning the battle. He even tells Belle, now it's 1-1. One win, one loss. The next time we fight, we shall settle this once and for all. And we had to it that Belle seems to be like he's okay with this loss, but he's really mad because he wanted to win. And I'm glad of that, you know? I'm glad Belle, you know, honestly, I'm glad Belle lost this episode because many people think, like, Belle should be winning. Many people must be upset and kind of, like, annoyed with Belle winning a lot and him being a chick magnet most of the time. But let's be honest, Asterius was a freaking monster, and I'm pretty sure he gotten stronger the times when he was training down the lower levels of the dungeon. We all know that. We all seen that or heard about it and rumors about it, and we get to see his power in that when he fought the Loki Familia, even Ice herself, you know? The fact that he's able to damage Ice and have Ice's body shaken and actually held his own against Bet, Tiona, and Tione, that shows that he's not some simple Black Minotaur that got... He wasn't some simple Black Minotaur that stayed around to do this and that. And Asterius, the fact that he came in at the nick of time and have all the Xenos return, you know, that's really a good thing. And everything seems to be back to normal. The Loki Familia is rumored to kill all the monsters, and you know, little Rookie survives. Hestia gets a visit from Hermes, and Hestia kicks him in the face in anger of what he has done. And then Lid and the others, they seem to be back okay, you know? As for Wina, she's fine. As for Asterius, he's gone to the lower levels to get stronger, obviously. So that means Bell can't slack around either. He did tell Bell, like, the next time we fight, we are settling this. And guess what? Asterius' arm is back on track. The arm he lost is back on. So it's not going to be an easy fight anymore. Let's be honest. I mean, Asterius literally beat Bell with only one arm. And he was like, what, somewhat tired and possibly injured his previous fight against the Loki Familia? It's not the fact that he beat Bell like that just shows that he is the true thing about being called a monster. And of course, you know, he seems to be very respectable and likable at the same time. I mean, he seems to consider Bell a true rival, seeing how he wants to see him again, and this time they will settle this, which I go like, oh, this is gonna be nice and slick. I look forward to that. And you know, the episode seems to end up with Ice and Bell talking to each other, and Bell asking Ice, hey, can you train with me, teach me how to fight again? And Ice is like, after all that's happened? And he says, yeah, can you? And Ice is like, you really don't play fair, huh? And we have to it that Bell declares that he wants to get stronger, you know, etc. I thought, and the episode ends off there. Apparently, there is an announcement from the commentaries from the discussion forum that I'm always doing my best to be a part of. There might be another OVA coming up soon, which I don't mind. I mean, like, if it's fan service here and there, I mean, yeah. Anyways, now to give you guys my final thoughts. I thought this season, and I'm pretty sure anyone could agree, depending on your situation, the criticism. And now, in terms of criticism, it's not really great and all, and I'm pretty sure it sucks for a lot of people in terms of anime elitists and all that. But for me, I thought it was a better season than season. This season is way better than season 2. Call me Crazy Milanakis or something, it's way better than season 2, even though it still has its issues and problems that doesn't fix that. But I still consider this season, like I said and repeating myself many times if I have to, much better than season 2. I mean, when it came to season 2, I thought it was slick in the first half, but when it came to the second half, that's when I think it kind of got a little out of place. But when it came to this season, I thought this season, like I said and repeating myself again, forgive me, is much better than season 2. Why do I think that? I think it's because the way how it is about monsters and humans seems to be the main theme about in this entire season, you know? Can they coexist? Can things work out? The question to that is usually depending on your perspective. For me, it could work out depending on the situation. You take steps slowly. But with all that's happening this season, I highly doubt it could happen. I don't think it won't happen. But, yeah. And the fights in this season, I thought it was pretty nice. And, you know, like I said, the fight with Bell and Asterius, like, it was... I think I need to go back on season 1 to see Bell fight that Minotaur again. And then compare it to this freaking season. Dang. It just reminds me too much nostalgia when I remember watching season 1 of Don Machi, like, many, many years ago. How long has it been? Let me take a look. I mean, all I know is we got our second season in 2019, etc., and then we got our third season in 2020. It's been 5 years, honestly. 5 effing years since season 1 of Don Machi, man. And then, of course, there was a movie in that, etc., before the season 2, I think. And then, yeah. Like I said, it's been 5 years since we had season 1. 5 years it was ongoing, dude. Oh my gosh. I just don't know how to feel right now, like I said. Okay, enough of that. Yeah, when it came to Season 3, it was about the coexistence of monsters and humans. Can that really work? That was the main theme, and the answer to that question, it usually depends on your own perspective. I know, etc. For me, I mean, like, I think I'm in the middle depending on the situation, because you know how humanity is, etc. But that aside, in terms of, like, action and other crazy stuff, I thought it was much better than Season 2. That much I am repeating myself and saying again, you know? With the characters, and then like action scenes, and then event scenes, with things being built up here and there, the Loki Familia, the Freya Familia, that was pretty slick. Although the Freya Familia only had one goal in mind, only had a small role like they had in season 2, they still did somewhat of a parting job. Even Freya seems to enjoy the fact of what happened here and there, you know? That aside, like I said, I thought it was a pretty slick and better season than season 2, you know. because of the monsters and humans coexistence theme, and then, you know, like I said, when it comes to, like, certain, like, scenes with, like, Belle and the others, and, you know, Belle fighting ice, protecting, and trying to be that kind of person of a hero, you know, and being a fool. Yeah, I really like Belle as a character throughout this season, because even though he may ruin his reputation, but his honor is restored, it shows a lot how much he cares for those he's bonded with. And, you know, let's be honest, there's a lot of people who would rather, like, not do anything and not save anyone because it's not right or just doesn't seem right in the normal people perspective's eyes. But guarantee it's going to be a lot of full of regrets after, you know? But that aside, like I said, I thought this season of Danmachi, again and again, repeating myself, is much better than season 2. So what would be my overall thoughts, you know? I mean, in terms of animation, art, characters, I thought they were really slick, so I give it maybe 8 to 9 out of 10. Music, as always, is always great for me, 10 out of 10. And then when it comes to story and its writing, you know, for the season, I thought it was really nice, etc. Although, like, I don't know how it's going to... Although, like, I'm looking forward to hopefully, like, it'll still have a role to play. Even the Xenos, Asterius, guarantee, we will see him again. But he's going to be very much stronger when he plans to settle this with Belle. I mean, the way how he beat Belle and slammed into the ground just proves how terrifying he is. Let's not forget that he fought the Locofamilia and held his own for a while now. That just proves he's not some... That he's not the same Minotaur that he was in season 1. He's a beast. And I like beasts. Anyways, Ice and Belle having to talk with each other again and make up. I thought that was really nice. The way how I think about Belle, he's not the guy who holds grudges, but he has an understanding. Which is something that grew on me, you know? There are some things you shouldn't hold against other people, even though, like, it goes against something else, you know? And trying to make amends, you know, is what really, really counts, and that takes a lot of guts. And I give props to Belle to make up with Ison, the person that he respects the most and fell in love with, etc. And I'm looking forward to seeing Belle's growth, you know? I'm pretty sure the adventure is not over yet. I've been doing my research about the light novels here and there, and it's not over. I don't know when they're going to make another season, but I really hope they could keep making seasons of Dungeon Girls until the light novels are over, and then they finish off with the finale, you know, like any other series, how they do it, you know? I mean, yeah. It's been a long ride, you know? 5 years started season 1, and up until now, 5 years going to season 3. Man, it's been one hell of a ride. Like I said, I love season 3 much better than season 2. What's my overall score? I'm thinking about maybe a 7 out of 10. But in terms of, like, real criticism, I guess, like, it's below that, depending on your situation, if you even look back of, like, the entirety of, like, from the beginning to the end. But hey, I still have my enjoyment out of it. The way how they finish off that finale with that big battle and then Ice and Belle making up, oh my gosh, it made me want to say it's been a fun ride. I really hope to see another season coming up soon. And people say that Belle's growth will continue to go above and beyond, and I can't wait to see Belle getting stronger, man. I mean, he may be young now, but once he keeps growing and training harder, he's gonna be he's not going to be a little rookie no more. He's going to be a real hero, which is his biggest dream, which I look forward to. So until then, people, thank you guys so much for listening to my big long talk or something. Looking forward to next episode. Hopefully it'll be slick and it'll be... I mean, it's over. I mean, hope you guys enjoyed this season as much as I did. Much better than season 2, as I'm repeating myself. And I'm looking forward to next season if they ever make one. And I hope they do make one. I'm pretty sure a lot of the anime community, despite they have some issues with it, seem to like it very much, you know? So until then, people, I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm Alpha Zero. Have a good day, and I'll see you guys next time, alright? Peace out. Bye-bye. Toot-toot-toot!